For 4 years, I have been homing this mill by lining painted reference lines manually using an MPG wheel. With the home switches installed, LinuxCNC provides software hard limits to the axes. And that means I can use the entire work envelope of the machine without fear of colliding against the end of travel of one of the axes. The sensors are 24-volt PNP normally closed inductive switches, the same type I used on my CNC lathe, and the reproducibility is a fraction of a millimeter. The switches are installed in places that should help protect them from coolant and chips, the top of the column, and underneath the table on this side toward the middle of the saddle. When all three axes have home switches installed, LinuxCNC axis shows a home all button. And once you press that, it'll begin the homing operation in the order specified in the NE file. That is, in this case, the Z axis will home first, then the X and Y axes will home concurrently. And the idea is any tool that might be contained within a pocket is pulled out. Once the limit is found, or the home position is found, then the mill continues to move to an origin position. And I place the origin position at the top of the Z travel, and the X and Y origin position is with the table centered underneath of the tool.
There are three parts of the machine, the targets for the inductive sensors. And these are machined from steel because the inductive sensors are more sensitive to steel than to aluminum. This is the X-axis target being machined. All the targets start with the same blank, but are slightly different to avoid holes in the target surface. The sensing envelope of the inductive sensors is tight enough that, for example, they can fall into the hole of an M5 cap head screw. And if that happens, the sensor doesn't see the target. Now I'm working on the Y and Z targets, and it's fun to show the difference between using coolant and not using coolant. It's all the same parameters, and other than a lot of heat, there's also a difference in how the chips form. The Y-axis homing switch target doesn't set well because the mating surfaces aren't square. We need the target surface to be parallel with the sensing surface of the switch. To measure the gap at the top of the target from the base, I use a 1 and a 1.5 millimeter drill bit.
The only thing you have to remember to use a sine vise is the length constant times sine of the angle is the height that needs to be stacked.
This is probably a 2 hour part, but I made it and it looks beautiful. Installation of the inductive sensors and targets is a lot of match drilling. Each part is held in place, a transfer punch is used to transfer the hole pattern to the mill, a center punch is used to create a nice base for the drill, the hole is drilled to a tap size, the hole is tapped, and the part is installed. The way LinuxCNC uses a homing switch is that it always searches in the same direction. You set the direction, but it will always search in that same direction until it detects the sensor. And then it backs off and then more slowly approaches the sensor. The axis can then be moved a known distance to a convenient starting location, in this case the upper limit of the Z axis, and set that as the origin for the axis. I'm checking the clearance between the vise and the mill at the extreme end of the Y travel. The accordion wayguard gets a little crushed at this position, but the ball nut collides with the mill's base before the vise collides with the mill. Homing with the inductive sensors is already accurate, but LinuxCNC can make the process even more accurate by using the index pulse from the motors so that after homing, the shaft is in a consistent orientation. There's enough overhang on the table's precision surface to install the X-axis home target and avoid collision with the saddle. The process is just nerve-wracking. You don't want to drill too deep, damage something, or break a tap off. It's important to verify the sensor can never get behind the target. It's okay for the sensor to pass over the target, but it must never get behind the target. After the X and Y axes are homed, their origin is in the center of their travel, and that way their limits are symmetric. That seemed convenient to me, but you might prefer to have the origin be at the extreme end of the travels of the axes. And that's what I do for the Z axis. Z0 is at the extreme upper limit of the Z axis. Again, it seemed convenient to me. Consider early in the process where you might install the home switches, but also consider more sophisticated motors that have absolute encoders. With absolute encoders, you could eliminate home switches entirely.
the home position would be programmed once relative to the absolute encoders, and homing would be done. Every time you turn on the machine, the home position or the distance to the home position would be known by virtue of having absolute encoders.